Okay, so you all got that. Okay, what are the names of the friends in Sex and the City? Yep. What have you got, Richard and David?
Carrie, Miranda, Samantha, and Gwen. we bottomed out at Gwen.
Gwen was a definite guess.
So
Carrie,
close.
We're pretty confident on. Sliding scale in between.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, Carol and Frank, you went for?
Carrie, Samantha. Well, Frank went for this because I could only remember two of them. Charlotte and Miranda. Get him. He's got all four. He said, don't tell me what they are, I know what they are. Like that.
Well done, you. Yeah. Alan, Jack.
And Carrie Bradshaw's on the next line. But it is there, you will see. With
have
question
you put
do you know what, Alan? I'm
going to
take
well.
Your word for that. I
Thank
think you probably got this one. Yeah, the answer was Charlotte, Carrie, Miranda, Samantha, which coincidentally is the order in which I would do them. Okay, next one. I asked, who was I being in this photo? What show was that? What'd you get?
Cheers.
Well done.
Cheers.
What did you go for, Carol and Frank?
We went for Cheers, obviously. It's a lovely
And Richard
pose.
And David?
We went for Cheers or How Clean Is Your House?
All right, let's have a little look.
She looks like Edwina Corrie.
She does look cheery.
You all get a point for Cheers. Next one. OK, Ricky Gervais asked you to name the show that confused The Sopranos' Uncle Junior. What did you think it was?
What did we say? Now, you see, we didn't have time to write it down. NYPD Blues, we thought.
OK, incorrect. OK, Jack and Alan?
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
OK, and Richard and David?
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
OK, let's go back to Ricky for the answer.
The answer is Curb Your Enthusiasm. You right? He won a competition. I don't know why he's old now. I'm mic'd up. I walk around mic'd up. Just wanted to. But you wish you had a shave now, don't you? Don't be embarrassed. Jimmy started off like this. And it wasn't a mic he was holding, let me tell you that.
Thanks very much, Ricky. You're both absolutely right. It was Curb Your Enthusiasm. Yeah. OK, let's have a look at the scores. Alan and Jack have 8 points. Carol and Frank have 8 points. Richard and David catching up with 6 points. Oh. Richard, you are our youngest panellist. You were how old when Channel 4 started?
5.
Do you remember anything about it?
I didn't mind it. I thought it was fine. it was all right. I approved it. I thought, yeah, go ahead. To be honest, I wasn't massively consulted on the whole process. I was kind of left out of a lot of key decisions in setting up the channel. I think we can see the fruits now. It's working out for the channel or for me as a man.
Right, now it's time for a bonus round all about talk shows. Sometimes a talk show will run and run like Parkies. Sometimes the audience will run and run like Davina's. Okay, some questions for you. Can you tell me which two Channel 4 chat show hosts were described by the Bee Gees as tosser and scum, respectively?
I'm getting the hang of this.
Good, yeah.
John Snow.
Okay, nice. You all got something?
Yeah, we've got something written down.
You got something, all right. Well, what have you got?
Well, Clive Anderson called them tossers, I think.
And they walked. One of them walked off, didn't he?
They all walked
off. No, they called him a tosser.
No.
He called them a tosser. They were in a band called something like the Tosser. And he said, "Well, you've been tossers ever since," and they all walked off. So I presume that they bounced that back at him.
Right back at you, said the Bee Gees.
And scum, we just guessed Terry Christian.
Well, you all got Clive Anderson.
He's terrified of losing that hand, isn't he? he's got the other one gripped tight on that bastard.
He's hiding the fact that at the time he had an ill-advised Egyptian beard.
you thought Clive Anderson was a tosser, and who do you think was scum?
Jon Snow.
Jon Snow, we thought, because he can be sort of a very... He can be a tough interviewer, I imagine.
We guessed.
But I imagine he'd take the Bee Gees to pieces.
It's not Jon Snow. It's not Terry Christian. Alan and Jack?
Graham Norton.
You're absolutely right.
Oh.
You get the points there. Well done. Yes, the Bee Gees called Clive Anderson a tosser and Graham Norton scum. Next question. Ring My Bell, hosted by Laurie Pike, briefly but oh so brightly lit up our screens in 1991, providing yet another twist on the talk show format. What was the twist of Ring My Bell?
Can I...
Shall we write it down? What
is it? Can you write it down?
Yeah, same as all the other questions this far. Nothing's changed, Vorderman. Look at that, she's whispering in Frank's ear. I'll be getting changed in the front room tonight. Oh, that new rug, so warm. OK, what do you think was unusual about Ring My Bell? What have you got, David and Richard?
It's the first and only campanology-based gag. It's literally some bell ringers from a church...
finding out what they were doing.
..interviewing, maybe... I mean, the Bee Gees didn't get on with them either.
They called them bellends, and they just, you know... Mm. Oh, come on, who cares?
OK, you're wrong, but point taken.
Thank you.
Carol and Frank, what have you gone with?
I sort of remember it, and I might be right. Was he like a shock jock in a radio studio? And people used to ring on the phone, and then he'd talk to them on the phone. So his talk show, his guests were on the phone.
Not quite. Alan and Jack, what have you gone with?
What I meant to say was there were celebrities, weren't there, in booths?
She spoke to celebrities, so that's the new twist on... The new twist on a chat show.
And listen.
Let him speak.
Hear me out, all right.
All right.
All right. What I meant was that members of the public could phone celebrities.
That is the right answer. You get a point. So do you, Frank and Carol. You're pretty close with that. You don't get a point for that.
No.
Let's have a little look from one of my favourite moments from Ring My Bell.
A buttock and one right boob.
Hey, did you show that right boob? I didn't see
yes,
that
just,
one.
Yes, just you got to look very quickly.
Oh God, was that in the one with the toothpaste?
What? No, that was camping.
Oh, I missed that one.
Well, I'll tell you, you're about the only person in the county. My girlfriend
didn't see that one. Otherwise, she would have had even more of a go at me, you know.
Anyway, you take care.
Oh, you bet I will
do.
I
know. God bless you, darling.
Love to see your tits.
Bye, love.
Bye,
bye. Bye.
Love to see your tits. Bye.
Was that Leslie Grantham had phoned up?
OK, after the break, we'll be talking about Channel 4's contribution to youth TV, shows like TFI Friday, which was called TFI to avoid saying unpleasant words no one wants to hear at tea time, like it's the Chris Evans show. See you after the break. Welcome back to the Big Fat Anniversary Quiz. Before Channel 4 came along, the only television made specifically for teenagers was the Clearasil ad. And once a month, John Noakes interviewed Dave Lee Travis about discos. Channel 4's youth shows were fronted by talented and beautiful young women like Danny Bear, Amanda de Cadenet and Janet Street Porter, to name but two. Then there was Max Headroom, an odd robotic performer with a square head, plastic-looking face and a side parting, which I think is a good look. Channel 4 also makes dramas for young people. Hollyoaks is not only entertaining, but also educational. Before Hollyoaks, I didn't even know how to rape a man.
If you do a Hollyoaks joke, you should have someone in the corner doing that for you.
Why?
Because when you watch Hollyoaks on the omnibus, there's always someone in the corner doing...
What did the singing man do when the man was arse-raped? What did the singing man
do? That's only if it came in dialogue. You know, presumably it was pictures.
You're going to mention it if you're arse-raped, didn't you?
Well, maybe he just tutted to himself and went...
Not again.
Boys will be boys.
What's he like?
OK, straight on to the questions about youth TV. If you're familiar with the annual Big Fat Quiz of the Year, you'll be delighted to know that the children of Mitchell Brook Primary School in Neasden have put on one of their unconventional school plays. What I want you to tell me is what notorious Channel 4 show are they depicting here?
Welcome to this show for grown-ups what loves lots of disgusting things.
And some music.